The human body is typically described in terms of tissues, organs, cells, and biochemical processes. But in addition to these, there is a very subtle form of light emitted by all living cells, real photons generated internally. Now, these emissions are not visible to the human eye because they are incredibly faint, approximately a billion times weaker than a candle flame. Yet, with the right instruments, as you'll see, this biogenic light can be measured. And interestingly, it appears to change in response to physiological processes such as healing, mental activity, and stress. Some researchers even suggest it may be involved in intercellular communication. This raises two important questions we'll look at in this video. Why do living systems emit light? And could that light have a biological function? Let's begin with what are biophotons. The term biophoton comes from bio, meaning life, and photon, meaning light. Essentially, the light of life. Biophotons are ultraweak emissions of visible and near visible light in the 200 to 800 nanometer range. These photons are emitted spontaneously by living organisms without external stimulation. Biophoton emission is not related to thermal radiation or reflected light. Instead, it is generated within the cell, often associated with oxidative metabolic processes, particularly those found in the mitochondria. Biophoton emission has been well documented in a wide range of organisms, including humans, animals, plants, insects, and even single-celled organisms. The intensity ranges from about 1 to 1,000 photons per square centimeter per second, so detecting this light requires highly sensitive equipment due to its extremely low intensity. Despite being overlooked for much of scientific history, biophotons are now recognized as a real, measurable feature of living systems. In order to understand more about it, we have to start with its historical references. In ancient Chinese, Indian, and Middle Eastern traditions, descriptions of a radiant body or life energy field are common. Now, while these accounts were not scientific in method, they reflect long-standing human observations that align with what we now call biophotons. Scientifically, the first structured investigation came in the 1920s, from Russian scientist Alexander Gorbachev. While studying onion root growth, he found that one growing root could stimulate another nearby, even without direct contact. He hypothesized the existence of a weak ultraviolet emission that he termed the mitogenetic ray. Although initially supported by some, Gorbachev's results were later challenged due to inconsistent replication. However, many modern researchers believe he may have been observing what we now call biophoton emission. Then in the 1950s and 60s, Soviet and German scientists began detecting ultraweak light from biological tissues in completely dark environments. These emissions were spontaneous and persistent and not dependent on external light sources. Key researchers included Vladimir Koznikev, who studied cell communication using light, and Inyosin, who proposed the concept of a bioplasma or biofield. The term biophoton was introduced in the 1970s by German physicist Fritz Albert Popp. He proposed that these emissions were not random but coherent, and possibly used for communication. Popp's study showed that healthy cells emitted more structured, rhythmic light, while cancer cells emitted more chaotic patterns. Though initially controversial, this work laid the foundation for the field of biophotonics. Biophoton emission was long assumed to be an incidental result of cellular metabolism. However, recent research suggests it may serve functional roles within the body. The emission rate of biophotons has been observed to vary depending on cellular activity. It increases during DNA replication, cell division, oxidative stress, inflammation, and healing. These correlations suggest that biophoton patterns may reflect the physiological state of the cell. Some researchers propose that biophotons could function as a signaling mechanism. Experimental evidence supports the idea that cells can detect and respond to the ultra-weak light emissions from nearby cells, even when separated by barriers that block chemical exchange. This form of non-chemical, non-electrical communication suggests a layer of biological interaction and intelligence that is only beginning to be understood. Studies have also shown that light emission increases in plants when part of the organism is injured. In humans and animals, changes in emission levels have been linked to mental states, such as stress or meditation. There is speculation that this light-based signaling could complement the body's existing communication systems. Additionally, it appears that biophotons can travel through tissues via pathways such as collagen fibers and the myelin sheaths of neurons. This suggests that tissues may function as wave guides, enabling targeted light transmissions throughout the body. These observations have led to the hypothesis that the body might host an internal optical communication network. Because biophoton emissions are extremely faint, detecting them requires highly controlled laboratory conditions. Researchers used dark chambers with velvet-lined interiors, light-sealed access points, and temperature-stabilized environments to minimize interference. The primary instruments used are photomultiplier tubes, or PMTs. These are capable of detecting single photons. These detectors are often cooled using thermoelectric or liquid nitrogen systems to reduce background thermal noise. Another key technology is the EMCCD, or electron multiplying charge coupled device. This is a camera that allows for spatial imaging of low-level light across samples. Unlike fluorescence or bioluminescence imaging, biophoton detection is passive. It captures the spontaneous emission of light without the need for excitation. The result is a visualization of photon emission as it occurs naturally in living tissue. The pattern that emerges shows variation by tissue type and physiological condition. For example, light emission from the brain may increase during periods of sensory input or focused attention. Emissions from the hands are often stronger from the torso, possibly due to structural or metabolic differences. These patterns are being mapped to explore their potential diagnostic value. This transition from detecting light to interpreting it marks a real turning point. Biophotons are no longer just a curiosity. They are becoming a measurable biomarker with real implications for physiology and medicine. I'm going to go over just a couple of recent findings here. If you think we need to dedicate a whole episode to some of this research, let me know in the comments below. But to summarize, in Canada, researchers developed photoencephalography, a method to measure real-time biophoton emission from the human head. The data showed light levels increased during auditory stimulation and mental focus, suggesting a correlation between cognitive function and photon emission. Other studies have demonstrated that biophotons travel preferentially along certain structures in the body, including collagen fibers and neural pathways wrapped in myelin. This supports the idea that tissue can serve as optical waveguides similar to fiber optic cables. A 2024 study found that applying mechanical stress to cells caused immediate changes in their photon emission profiles, pointing to a rapid light-based response to environmental stimuli. In plants, biophoton emissions increased in structured pulses during seed germination and root development, suggesting an organizational role during early growth. Now, on the quantum side, some researchers propose that biophoton emissions may exhibit quantum entanglement, especially in neural tissues. Experimental studies have also shown that biological molecules such as tryptophan can emit coherent, laser-like bursts of light, called super radiance. These findings provide compelling evidence that biophotons are not just metabolic byproducts, but may serve as active participants in biological regulation. Understanding biophoton emissions has implications for both basic science and medical application. Light emission correlates with cellular health, Healthy cells tend to produce rhythmic and coherent photon patterns, while diseased or stressed cells emit more chaotic light. This makes biophoton measurements a potential for non-invasive biomarking. Applications currently under development include diagnostic systems that detect early signs of disease based on biophoton signatures, optical methods for monitoring brain activity that complement or potentially replace EEG, experimental therapies that use light cues to support tissue regeneration in skin, bone, or nerve tissues. Now, while much of this field is still in early development, the growing body of evidence suggests that biophotons may provide a new layer of insight into biological function. I hope the main takeaway is that biophotons are real, measurable, and meaningful. The evidence so far points towards a light-based layer of biological signaling that operates alongside chemical and electrical processes. From ancient concepts to modern labs, the idea that the body emits light has gained renewed attention through rigorous study. And as we continue to refine our tools and understanding, biophoton research may help answer broader questions about how life communicates, adapts, and repairs. If any of this you want to go into more detail or you find an interesting publication, drop it in the comments below or send me an email. I so appreciate your time, and until next time, take care.